making moves in a sumbulu somkomelo wemali over 50,000 rand
to invest in a business.
13 entrepreneurs will get a chance to showcase their businesses. Each entrepreneur will get an opportunity to pitch for this investment into their business. The judges will use their own discretion. We'll go through to our final episode where they will battle it out for the grand prize. Ukele Making Moves, njalo ngomsombuluko, ko 2 p.m. ku SABC 1, Mzansi for sure.
Especially with the 50,000, what we looked at was to develop a structure of about 12 by 6 meters, steel structure, but the total cost of it is 70,000.
It's a competition. Everybody's sitting there and wants this 50K. And you're telling me that you're going to use this 50K for a certain structure that is not critical to the business.
Well, I'll take that one. Oh, okay.
Farming has always been an industry not usually associated with young people, particularly black females. Kodwa ke kule minyaka lena ke eseyidlulileke sesiyanda isibalo sabantu abamnyama abangena ke kuwona ke lo mkhakha lona. Uphinde ukhumbule ukuthi uhulumeni wethu udlala iqhaza elikhulu kakhulu ekusizeni ke ukuthi kube khona ke abantu abamnyama abangena kuwona ke lo mkhakha lo. Lokho ke futhi kuphinde ke kulungiseke ngendlela ke lo mkhakha lo ubukeka ngakhona. Ithuba projects enye ke yamanye ama cooperatives akhona kuyona le nkundla le. Lapha sikhuluma ngabantu abamnyama abasha abazakhela indume ezulu kuwona lo mkhakha.
Ika malami upetrune wakamumakwe ngisebenza khona la eithuba siba u7 ama founder wayo le cooperative esikwenzayo la senza I livestock siphinde futhi senze ne crop mangikhuluma ngokuthi senze livestock ngikhuluma ngokuthi sinezimvu siphinde futhi sibe nenkomo inkomo ze tesinazo njengamanje ziz 214 ezikhona ama calf weight ay 73 izimvu ezikhona manje is 120 mase seyiphelele zizonke.
Ngizohlangana noPetunia osebenzela khona ke lapha kuleli plaza engime kulona lase Flakfontein yena ke ehlangene nethimba lakhe ke labanye osomabhizinisi into engifuna ukuyazi ukuthi ke lo mhlaba lona kwaleli plaza bawuthola kanjani futhi njengoba bethi ke bona ke bayabalimi futhi bangama-farmers benza ini ke kabanzi enye into engithokozisayo ngizoke ngifunde kabanzi ke ngawo ke lo mkhakhalo akubuke nazi iy'nkomo ngemuva ke azizinhlebo madoda ake ngixoxisana naye ke lona wesimame ngizokuthi leli bhizinisi labo basebenza kanjani njengoba leli team engathi ke futhi ke like lithi kuba baningana kulona nangiya lapha ake sishone khona. Aw, ngonkonko. Sisiphethini?
Yebo.
Kunjani dadwethu?
Yaphunjani futhi?
Hey, siyaphila kudaka umhlolo.
Hey, imvula, hey.
Ngiyazi ukuthi unethimba osebenzisana nalo.
Yebo mama.
Hayi siqale la. Nibangaki nje kule co-op kuthiwa ni team?
Si-7.
Sikhombisa.
Yebo.
Nahlangana kanjani ukuze ni decide ukuthi ake sihlangane sonke siyiqembu nizosungula yonke lento enayo namhlanje?
Ukuhlangana kwethu sahlanganela endaweni ebizwa ukuthi iBuhle Farmers Academy.
Yeah.
Isikolo leso cishe se-agriculture siseDelmas.
Mm-hmm.
Yebo, ukuhlangana kwethu lapho we're doing i-crop production.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, kwenzeka ukuthi the more kuhamba isikhathi sizaze sakwafika la sigraduate khona.
Mm-hmm.
After our graduation that kuba khona icompany called Tongatwile Starch.
Mm-hmm.
Izo approach le sikolo sasifunda kiso iBuhle.
Mm-hmm.
Ukuthi idinga ama student amasecedile azoyenza more practical.
Mm-hmm.
Which ethically prefer.
Yes,
yes.
Uh-huh.
After there we go la eBalf. Mm-hmm. A crop flare. Yes. Mm-hmm. Si establish ithuba ngo 2009.
Yeah.
Yes.
Njengoba usushilo ukuthi nisikhombisa uma senhlangene ke nawo abanye ngale ngiyababona singathi kuyakhona siyoxoxisana nawo.
Cha, I think inga singahamba but.
Ehhe.
njani ngangamele?
Ah, siyaphila ba.
Ya, siyaphila kodwa umkhalakusizwe, khalakusizwe.
Ya.
Ah, ngiyazi ukuthi hayi niloku nibambile la ekhaya.
Hey, sayibamba mfowa ikhenya.
Yayikhenya. Ehhe. Johnny 7 ke, masimpheleni isikhombisa, ubani owenza ini? Ononke nje ningena khona ke la eplazini.
Hayi, lutho lutho sihlukene kathathu.
Yes.
Sine committee lethu elibhekele ikhop yonke.
Yes.
Umama njengoba umphathi wethu and then sine committee elibukele ngaka crop. Lezo zokulima emasimini sine committee elibukele nangapha futhi einkomeni.
So yini hlehleni yenza kahle la?
Oh, thina hayi siyenza imix, mix farming. Asibekanga kuphela embileni, sibekena seinkomeni because umbila uthatha isikhathi ukuthi umature, sikhuluma about 7 to 8, 9 months. So within leso sikhathi leso kumele sibe leso income ezwenza ukuthi at least iplazi loko likhona ukuchubeka sisebenza. So sasesifaka iy'nkomo-ke because nazi iy'nkomo i-long term investment. Sabothi okay, sishoda ngale mali encane nje yokuthenga ama-leaks nani nani nemijovo, safaka izimvu-ke. Sathi ya lapho-ke izokhona ukuthi ivale leyo gap leyo uma sisalinde 8 months ukuthi zikhule. In 6 months ikhona esikukhiphayo ezimvini.
Ngiyabonga bhuti wami, nazi-ke nazo angazi-ke seziyakubiza zithi zifuna ukuzozinakekela.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Spanisan le ba ke spana le bone o ithuta ntho tsengata so ke ntwe leng gore at the end of the day o dula o etlwetse like a daily bread ya ha ho sengwa bone then it's nice total gone mo botsolong ba ke se ke a tseba gore farming it's life ntho a mathomo because of without farming re ka se kgone go ba le dijo South Africa is a whole e se nna ke le one so ke ntho e leng gore ga e thuse nna ke le one but then le batho ba bang kontle ya kgona go ba thusa in terms of dijo like starch vel we get it from farming beef it's all about farming all those things so life wise ga e nthuse nna ke le one even South Africa is a whole.
So wena ke nje mihla namalanga wena mhlawumbe uphakathi kwa ugandaganda noma wena wenza ukuhlukile la ekhaya.
Cha sonke ngiyaw travel ugandaganda ngiba namalanga ngiw drive kodwa nabanye khona baba namalanga not ukuthi all the time is going to be umuntu oyiwani. Yebo.
So mabe sesihlanganisa wonke lo mhlaba ulana ke seninawo ke sikhuluma ngama hectare amangaki ke wonke.
3000 hectares the whole farm.
Ehhe.
Last tshala khona.
Yebo.
It's 1,500, yes.
Ehe. So njoba lana ngibonile buloku usama ngogandaganda nitshala ini ke kule ndawo?
Kule ndawo kule season endlulile besitshale i-sugar beans.
Yeah.
Kodwa manje sesenza le nto abayibiza ngokuthi crop rotation which sizotshala i-white maize.
Oh.
Kule season njengoba singakabhatha sikakaqali but sesilungiselele ukuthi sizotshala yona i-white maize.
Ehe.
Yebo baba.
Uyabona le nkundleni kuyona lena eyamafamu noma ekuba balimi nento enjalo-ke akuyona inkundla lena umuntu angathi ufake imali namhlanje kusasa isiyaphuma. Nina-ke imali-ke niyeni-generate kanjani ukuze nazisho ukuthi le plazi lenu nefamu nakonke okukhona kuhlezi kukhona kusebenzeka nina nikwazi ukuthola futhi nemiholo iminyanga iphela.
Njengoba usho ukuthi is not easy ukuthi si-generate income sithole manje. Yebo, njengoba sizofaka lo sizohlanyela lo mbila manje sizo-harvesta next year September. Yebo. Siphila kanjani? Yabona sineenkomo ne?
Yes.
Sinezimvu.
Yebo.
Sithengisa izimvu uma sesibona ukuthi kukhona la before ngifika lapho. Seasonally, njengoba sizosenza i-harvest yethu, sine-budget. Sihlala phansi ukuthi okay, fine, running off the farm, salaries, vaccination, enkomeni, yonke lento nokudla kwenkomo, siphutha on a budget. Le mali masithola sesivele already sekwi-budget khona lapha e-bank, sibikelele zonke le zinto lezo. But throughout the year, khona ama-challenges esiba nawo ku-business. Siyakhona nokukhipha enkomeni, sikhipha inkomo, siyithengisela. Fana nakule 2 months ago. Yes, bekunama-challenges amakhulu kakhulu la eplazini. We have ukuthi sibhadale i-lease. So imali besinayo beyincane kakhulu. Due to ukuthi sifake ku-running of the farm or singeza futhi nala ma-salaries, sadecide ukuthi okay, fine. Inkomo zethu sesikhona lezi esingakhona ukuthi sithengisele. Was around about 107.
Inkomo?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, ama-winners esiwathengisile khona lapho. Imali esitholile, I can say irang i-round of needs 300,000.
Yes.
Who are you supplying largely?
Mostly now it's at Afgri Silos.
Okay. Yes. That's the only person you supply?
Yes.
Not good enough for me.
Petunia was exposed to farming from an early age. Pelage enake kwakungumuntu ojwayele ukusebenza eplazini likamkhulu wakhe ngesikhathi samaholiday. Sitholeke isikhathi sokuthi sixoxisane naye nabantu abamazi kabanzi ukuze basitshele ukuthi-ke le ntokazi yiziphi-ke izinto-ke ezaguqula-ke futhi-ke zashape-a nempilo yakhe.
Professionalo umntana bekathanda izinto ezinhle alandelela ene athanda isikolo nomsebenzi wakhe bowunqomeka esikolweni
bese ifamily nje bese ifamily ephuka kahle kahle so othola ukuthi idistance lama transport abo scholar transportation especially bebangekho leso sikhathi leso Uthola ukuthi maka esikolweni usuka ngenyawo like up 7 km uya esikolweni and uyaya uyabuya uthola ukuthi isikhathi akuna mali yomkhero but beka manager nje ukuthi akwenze lokho umntana nje kahle kahle xa bekasebenza hard azimisele
ukukhula kwami ngikhulele endaweni yasemaplazini kahle kahle kakhulu kona by that time ngikhula bengayiboni inkinga cause ngikhula nabafana kakhulu
upeshuna ukukhula kwakhe bekashayi umuntu osabayo but the more akhula the more ashintsha
bekamntana nje right unama jokes kahle kahle into bekayithanda kakhulu bekaphiwe la ku-sports
Yeah, bekathanda netball, bekathanda ukugijima. Uthanda ukufunda. Bokuyilo.
Uyabathanda abantwana. And asu umuntu ovuma ukuhlukana nabantwana bakhe. And uyazibambela abantwaneni, uyazenzela. Akusu umuntu ofuna ukuphathelwa. Ukuba umama ne kahle kahle I don't think ukuthi mina kukhona la kungishintshe khona or kukhona la kwenzeka khona kanjani because even at home masikhula ukhula nje uyenze eminye imisebenzi uyabona nomama uyakufundisa nje mina for mina ngiyabathanda nje abantwana bami kakhulu ngiyabathanda and angifuni nje ngabo futhi yebo so I don't think kukhona la kushintshe khona or kukhona la kunani khona because even le mara ukuthi iqhubeka ihamba ngale ndlela it's even i-account nasemsebenzini uyabona because most la ngisebenza khona manje as ngiyenza le farming abomama sibancane abobaba uyabona i-majority nawe lapho khona la kumele uplaye khona i-role yobumama uyabona so ngicabanga ukuthi into e-right kakhulu for me
kulo bekayi bekalima kahle kahle ifamily vele vela ku farming so kwenzeka boma 87 bamkhipha la belu 1987 la Pepsi so kwathola ukuthi ifamily iba skathatha bathatha le la plaza lapha ba balisebenzisa bona so sakhishwa ke team
azange vele kusaba khona ubumnandi sesithuthile siloku sikhalela leya ndawo kamkhulu kodwa ingekho into esizoyenza kungekho futhi umuntu ozosilwela ukusuka kwethu ke sesihlelile eRumfontein
abantwana zangeke bayithandi nawo sokhlungfontini ukusuka kwabo bakha la ngathi mina yakhani nje umkhukhuni ingakho indawo enkulu just ukuthi nikhone travel niye esikolweni
impilo bebayimele waphinda futhi yonke into yabona yakhama down we have ukuthi kulekha lapho nalapho yabona everyone phakathi kwami nokhola nobrancos sasiwisha ukuthi uyabona mangikhulu if nangiqeda isikolo ngifuna ukuyofunda ngifuna ukuthola umsebenzi ngenze 1-2-3 ekhaya we even build this house mina nokhola nobrenda yes by ukuthi sesithole la sisebenza khona sesithola lokhu kuncane sikuthola ukuthi no asihlanganiseni sicontributing sithenge nitini siyibekeni because into vele sasifisa ukuthi sifuna ukwenza ukuthi sibe nekhaya eli-right mase sikhulile.
Ithuba Cooperative yona kuyasungulwa ngonyaka ka-2009 kodwa-ke sebehlangene nobunzima obuthi zathi izendleleni zabo-ke zokuba osomabhizinisi. Njengamanje-ke bona-ke bathola-ke izindlela-ke ezahlukahlukene ezingabasiza ukuthi basebenzise lokhu abanako ukuze bakwazi ukuthola umcebo. Basestudio njengamanje uxoxisana noPepsi ukuze bamtshele ukuthi imaphi-ke amasu abanawo-ke azobasiza ukuthi bakwazi ukudayisa lokhu abanako to a formal market.
Ukufika la ku making moves eh kodwa kuthukathukekile kancane manje
yeah hayi nami ngiyaziva nje ukuthuka kuncane but cause angazi kuzoyenza kanjani but I'm looking forward ukuthi sibone phakathi ukuthi siyenza kanjani lovalo ngicabanga nje ukuthi into engasidisturb
especially la ku coaching side abona uma singathola kakhulukhulu la ku coaching marketing hayi soba right kakhulu
even interview cause since sihamba la sazi ukuthi sibona izoyenzakalani phakathi
hayi sobona khona
yebo hayi.
Ithuba Cooperative was formed by 7 members who met whilst studying at Buhle Farmers Academy. 7 years later, I'm interested to find out what is the reason for the slow growth in the business and get a little bit into the dynamics of a cooperative. Guys, welcome to Making Moves. It's very good to have farmers that look like farmers. cool farmers like to come here and bagqoke amasuit. And it's difficult to believe that they are farmers. But you've got the felt schooner. Can you guys show the felt schooner, please come? Yeah, the felt schooner and the farmer's t-shirt. So let's talk. I mean, often it becomes quite difficult, makhuluma nama farmer, because they talk in cows and hectares and those kinds of things. And I think it gets lost, kute, farming is a business, so we talk in money.
Exactly.
So let's start with the most important question. Is the farm making money?
Yeah, we are.
Okay.
Yeah, we are. Although asga richi potential is funu kufika kuyo, but at least we are making enough to survive.
Okay.
Yeah.
So define survive. So you can have a salary for yourselves?
Yeah, yes, salaries, but I my bills, at least and maintain the plus itself as well, because now I'm a customer from fencing to Woodlawinkomo, you see. Yeah, it's quite a lot of cost involved.
All right, so what is it then going to take for the business to do the kinds of numbers that you want? So when you imagine in your head to say, okay, when we project, we're really successful now, what does that look like? What's that number?
Well, that number would be about at least the profit. We're looking at least 10, 12 million.
Per annum?
Per annum.
Okay.
Yeah.
10, 12 million per annum?
Yeah.
And Konamanje, you're sitting at around?
Ah, it fluctuates depending on the season.
So let's talk about the average of the last 3 years.
It's about 1.2 million at times.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we could say mthambe 1.5. We take the last 3 years, average it out, divided by three, we're looking at what? Like, call it 1.2.
Yeah.
Okay, so 1.2 is our average for the last 3 years. Shugoti, we've got to grow to get to, you said 10 to 12 million a year. We've got to grow the business 8 to 10 times. How do we do that?
Like the farm where we are planting now, it's around about 1,500 hectares. But as a business, we have 600 hectares on our own. 800 hectares is for a partner. In paying, it's gonna pay us with the machinery.
Yes, for the whole purpose of that, we want to do the whole farm on our own so that we can achieve konke lokho sifuna ukukwenza ku business.
Okay, so how much of your land are you using for the crop farming?
It's about 600 hectares of it. The total land is 1,005, mm-hmm. which we use in total, mm-hmm. yonke, for ukufama. Mm-hmm. But because of, as she has explained, which we've got a partnership, ne? But on our side, as Ituba, for now, up until the next 3 years to come, we're only going to be using 300 on our side mm-hmm. alone. And then the other 800 is where we with the partner.
On that 600 hectares, are you going to be able to grow your business 8 to 10 times?
No.
Okay.
That's why we phased it out in two ways, Obo. Mm-hmm. As it started to go to home, we had phase one, which was to build up the livestock. Now it's standing on its own. Now we're on phase two, second year of phase two. Mm-hmm. So we left with 3 years. And then the partner moves out. At least we've got mechanization that we can use as insurance as we apply for a loan for other mechanization. So it's gonna take us about 6-7 years from 4 years from now on, at least to reach
that growth.
Yes.
Okay.
Because as soon as after 5 years, we'll be working on planting
the whole field.
So
who takes care of the business side of the farm and our legal agreements, the bookkeeping, the tax and those kinds of things? Who's taking care of that now?
Okay, let me break it down a bit. On the side of legality and the communication with the department as well as other relevant stakeholders, at the present moment, I'm taking care of that. And then the business itself, we've got Upechuna, who's got his committee now, who are overseeing that the business complies with everything that it needs to comply with. I mean, I'm talking the likes of pay as you earn. And in addition to that, we've got also a bookkeeper, Kheleng and Kheleng, who's also been quite helpful in terms of making sure that we've got the audited financial statement. We've got everything that has to do with
SARS. Is the bookkeeper full-time in the business?
No, it's only part-time.
Only part-time.
Yeah.
Which of you, amongst the seven of you, or anybody else in the business could be called more of a managing director or somebody that's an operations manager that takes care of the business?
The closest person we have who was able to look at those cross-general and everything like that, Sakele Manata. He's quite good with accounting. Mm-hmm. He's also trying to familiarize himself. Because you understand, some of the things we learn as we go. Because when it started, it was all the field. Mm-hmm. That's all was running on our mind. But as we grow, we realize it. But there's more to what we do in the field, in the business itself. So we need to look at somebody who's going to do the journals, who's going to balance the day-to-day running of the business in terms of how much did we spend today, how much did we get today, if there was any income today. You understand?
Is he an employee, a partner?
No, he's a partner as well.
Full-time?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Okay. My suggestion is maybe look at a board of directors. Go identify people that you respect and other people that are not necessarily related to farming, and come and form a board of just advisors that can look at the different challenges in the business and help you make business decisions. And also I do think maybe dedicate a little bit more time to learning about the business side of farming so that you can make better decisions. So I'm sending you off to spend some time with a friend of mine, Lucas, who'll also give you some advice and maybe give you some ideas. And hopefully that opens up a new relationship for you guys. It's very evident that Ituba's team is very passionate and they're determined to make this business work. But they need a lot of help with marketing and business skills. So they're now going to sit with one of our very experienced business coaches to help them through their current challenges.
Yeah, interview yethu ngasho nje ukuthi beyihambe kahle kakhulu and I hope ukuthi kube i-opportunity kimi ukuza ku-making move, because omunye nomunye lo okhona ekhaya obhekile can be a funder from government, whoever stakeholder la omunye nomunye, ngicabanga ukuthi singathola usizo not kwa-making move only.
Let's start here. What is your vision?
It's
quite big, though.
Let's see.
It's quite big because one of the most important things that we want to look at, of course, it will be growing ourselves first. Yeah. We need to look at the fact whereby we'll be able to not only have an abattoir, but with a butcher as well, where the business will be fully mechanized with all the mechanization and everything. And the biggest thing as well is contributing towards job creation as well, where we can be able to take in young farmers as well under our pillar, like train them, and work with the government as well to allocate lands for them.
You see, when it comes to vision, the question I ask is one. I say to people, your why, or what is your why? Why are you doing it? And that's the vision. Because that tells you that in the midst of all troubles and everything that's going to happen, I'm going to remember the why, because this is why I'm doing it. And that is going to keep them on the path.
Why is he last gone? I think you are going to lose your wins because we were clear, but maybe Lapuna Lapovisna is with Melistin because it's a funai with his produce, Catalas corn, so that we can improve our economy. Yes.
What main crop are you doing at the moment?
It's maize.
You do maize?
Yes.
How much maize?
Are we looking at about 5 to 1,000 tons?
Who are you supplying largely?
Mostly now it's at
Afgri
Silos.
Okay.
Yes.
That's the only person you supply?
Yes.
Not good enough for me. I've got a big problem with businesses that are running from one client. When a person is employed by one employer. If a person runs a business with one client, they're a freelancer.
Definitely, that could tell a high or go rent a team move it. It was Shabanangli marketing movie so that the Honobona or where else can we market ourselves and our produce instead of being dependent on one person or pieces.
What I'm trying to say to you is that don't look at one client and that client owns your value chain. They own your business. They even dictate the price to you because if you don't give them for that price, they don't buy from you. Okay, the danger of what you have is exactly that. If they go out of business, you are out of business. Number two, they can dictate the price to you because they are the only ones buying from you. If their business declines, you have a problem. If they meet someone else who gives them the better service, you've got a problem. So I want you to go and fix that. Make sure that you get a little bit more clients into your business.
Since this now, lama point uti mele silungi se wupinga banguti maspuma la logo kala mele so focus agiwo manje the structure go onkenje samu uti si try uti si build up eshlangani. I hope tomorrow ipichi tuzo hambaga.
Hey, inzima like it's in a struggle kitchen missing go. But Nyakabangu no eyes fundile and nani size armasit we bump.
Jungova Kamale, Lengambani Ashuti, ituba. Nani gets a wee tuba lane within Gene Yangali. New pitcher, Amachas Matatu, Banlindi.
Sabanga
Shonan Con.
Thank you.
You're tatting a little tuba in 70s.
Assault at a bed.
Welcome back, guys. How are you?
Good. And you?
Fantastic. Are you ready for your pitch?
Yes, we are.
Have you guys got a presentation?
Yes.
Yes, we do.
Okay. I don't see anything up on the screen.
No, we're not going to be doing it on the screen. It's just the piece of papers that we've handed over to you. That's why I'm presenting it.
Okay, well, best of luck. I have never seen it done that way, but we wish you the best of luck.
Okay.
My partners in crime, my fellow judges, Martin, Lucas, you've met. You had a coaching session with him yesterday.
Yes.
Your 4 minutes to sell your business to us. Tell us why we should give you money and what you intend to do with that money. And that 4 minutes starts now.
Okay, my name is Petuna Momakwe. I'm from originally in Telmas, but by work I'm at Balfour under a company called Ichuba. We met at Buhle Farmers Academy 2006 undergoing course of crop production. It was 9 months and covered all complete of crop production season. In 2007, there was a company called Tongatwile Stash come to the school where we are and approach the school that they want a graduate group of students that they can go in their place to do more practicals. That's where we were moving to Tongatwile Stash to start more practical in 2007 in October. We go there and do our practicals, which was we were planting on 124 hectares of land, and we were after harvest, we were selling them as our markets. In 2008, Tongatwile Stash helped us to get a farm with through Department of Land Affairs. That's how we transferred to that farm, which we are now at Balfour, which is Ituba. There, we start there having the contract between us and Tongat that we are going to how we're going to work. We are under a mentorship program by that time, and the size of the farm is 3,000 hectares, and the farm is under this government. We start working there for 3 years with Tongatwile Stash, but there was no motive on our side, like the business. We didn't see where we are going with Tonga. That's how we decided in 2011 that we want to part ways. That's where we start to operate the business on our own in 2012.
We've got 2 minutes left.
Okay. As my partners just explained, let me take you through a bit to some of our financial statements in terms of last year. It's on the second page. Luckily enough, the business in 2015 was able to make a profit of 547,216 as we closed the books. And as we opened the books on the 21st of August, we had an amount of 1,676,548,000. And then moving on again, the plan that we had on the business was a partnership plan whereby we had a 5-year partnership plan, which was at the value of 8,800,000, where the amount of money was to be used for mechanization. Up to so far, we've only used 3 million, and we have an outstanding million of 5,500,800,000 that we still need to use to purchase on the implements and mechanization. We're on our second year under that partnership. And furthermore, again, coming to some of the plans that we have, especially with the 50,000, what we looked at was to develop a structure of about 12 by 6 meters, steel structure, but the total cost of it is 70,000. So that means that the business will be short of 20,000. If it does get the 50,000, then the business will have to get an extra 20,000 to make up for the difference for that structure. The structure mainly is to be used for the storage of our most valuable equipment. I'm talking about our 12-row planter, which is at the value of 1,350,000. So for us to erect that structure, it will enable us to have a longer life on that planter so that we can use it not only for the next 5 years, but as well for the next 10 years, because if it's under a nicely stored pace, it means that it will not have any damage from the sun nor from the rain. So its deterioration will take
long.
Thank
you very much for your pitch. We're going to go into a short question and answer session. Brian Lucas, can I start with you?
Yeah. How important is the structure? And this is you're getting 50K in that. It's a competition. Everybody's sitting there and wants this 50K. For other businesses, it's a matter of life or death, this 50K. And you're telling me that you're going to use this 50K for a certain structure that is not critical to the business.
Lucas, in a sense, it is important because now we're talking about looking after what the business has already spent money on, because the planter itself alone needs to be kept in a dry place where it's not going to get rain or direct sunlight.
How much have you spent for the plant?
For the planter, it's 1,350,000.
So you bought something for 1 million and you can't put up a structure of 70,000 for it?
Yeah, it comes again, Mr. Lucas, to the coaching session that we had yesterday. Like you said, up until we meet a pothole, we do not think of it. So those are some of the things that we've taken into consideration, because on the 50,000 was something different, but then we realized, Uti, but we've hit a pothole and it was a mistake that, again, that we did. We bought an implement, but we didn't have a place to keep it. So we took that into consideration.
Last question for me, where is the business going?
Well, I'm going to take that one. Okay, well, with what we've learned in a couple of days, we believe that if we go back and implement some of the things that we've been taught, we stand a good chance of taking the business to a greater place, because avoiding situations whereby we'll be stuck with implements and no place to put them is a good start for us to see it if we work around those ways.
Martin, any comments?
Maybe I didn't understand correctly. You said you needed to spend 8.3 million.
Yes.
Right, and you spend 3.3 million, yes. And you still need to spend 5.5 million.
Yes.
Where's this money?
Oh,
whose money is this?
The money is through a strategic partnership that we have with one of the neighboring farmers. So with the Department of Land Reform, what we agreed upon is that for that money, we'll only use the money to buy mechanization, to mechanize the farm to fully operate on its own. Because it has become a big challenge for us to get mechanization, especially if you've got no financial record and it becomes difficult to get loans if you don't have any securities. So we came up with a plan that will allow us to have mechanization and at the same time be able to operate on the farm.
All right, so firstly, I mean, congratulations. I think you guys have done well. Since 2012, you've been operating. You started your financial year 2015. I mean, you made a big loss in 2015.
Yes.
Because you made a big loss because of the drought. But you started the year with 1.1 million already in the bank, which was able to sustain that loss and help you through the year.
Yes.
And you made a nice profit in the year ending 2016. So you've done well. Mm-hmm. How much money have you got in the bank today?
666,000.
You've got 666,000 in the bank today.
Yes.
Yes.
And you want us to give you 50,000 so that you can build a 70,000 rand structure for your 1.3 million rand machine.
Maybe we didn't even explain it. Now we have to pay the input to the farm. Yes, we are going to pay them after it's going to be reduced. Around maybe we will left about maybe 200,000. So, on our account.
I'll say you paid the thing. Yes. Okay.
And
all right.
Through that 200,000, we still need to look at the salaries as well. So, that's why it's going to push us from December and January with all the salaries expenses and some of the minor expenses. Okay. And then by March, we should be selling cows that will at least be able to sustain the farm up until June, July.
Okay. Guys, thank you very much. Last comment from me is you sound like what you actually need is some operational capital. Because even if you get 50K today, you're going to run out of money before March when you start selling cows. So you're in a bit of trouble already.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much. We'll deliberate and then call you guys back.
Thanks, guys. Right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I see you think 4 minutes is quite a long time, and then up until you're on stage.
Yeah.
But I think we gave it our best. That's all that's important.
Because they even comment ukuthi we need more. Yes, this 50,000 is like maybe ngani imali singafakele lakiyo. Yes, I think so. But anyway, powers agibo. Feedback yonke sesizovakona ukuthi bathini.
All right, guys, Ituba, another farming business. It's been a while since we've had a farming business on the show. What do you guys think, Martin?
Great business. Really, really great business. I just don't think we can help them.
So.
I don't think 50,000 is going to make a dent in what they need right now.
abakwayithuba. Nizwa kanjani ngakonke lokho kwenzakile laphakathi?
Eish. Hayi ngiyacabanga ukuthi sinikele ngakonke singakhona ukunikela ngako mntaka baba. Kodwa siyacabanga ukuthi sesizwa khona ukuthi khambeke kahle noma khambeke kanjani kodwa hayi cha. Sinikele ngako sinako.
They're in trouble. So 50k will make a difference. The issue is if they get 50k and they buy and they build their structure, it's actually not going to make any difference to getting them to the end of this financial year.
You see, that's where my thing is, Pepsi. And their pitch, I'm happy with their business. My biggest problem is what they want to do with the money. So if they take 50k and they put it in the structure, the business may collapse with a machine that's sitting under a structure.
Dadwethu, niphichile. Ucabanga ukuthi le pitch yenu lena eniyenzile ingabe ibe enough ukuthi singanibona ndlela lokusabe silandelayo noma khona mhlawumbe ningafisa ukuthi ngakushintsha ngawo?
Angeke ngize ngisho but mina nje bengicabanga ukuthi bekhona okunye besingaku-add yabona due to isikhathi. Azange sikhone ukuthi sikuveze. Uyabona, yes, but ngaloko I don't know ukuthi amajaji wona azodecide kanjani. Yes.
You know, in other businesses in this competition, they're one of the biggest businesses that have come through. That amount of money is going to make a marginal, really make, whereas with a small shop or some of the other businesses that we've seen,
huge impact.
50K will make a massive difference to their business. That's the first thing. The second thing is exactly what you've said, to say, maybe they're totally putting it in the wrong place.
Thank you. Let's find out.
Welcome back, guys. But you know, I forgot to say, you don't look like a farmer today. You look absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you. Ne?
Firstly, you have got an amazing business. You guys have done well. In the short time that you've existed, not many people are able to be successful farmers. And you guys are doing it. And I think in a few years, if you keep doing the same things you're doing, in a few years, you're going to be very far. I feel like you're lacking in corporate structure. You know, we spoke a little bit about it yesterday to say, you know, who's actually running the operations? Who's running the business side? Who's taking care of the legal side? And you said, no, I am. And I was like, Chief, you're the wrong person to be taking care of, like, the legal and the operations and whatnot. So that's my comment. Marty?
You know, I think it came through very strongly that your operational requirement is not a shelter for some implements, right? Go and have a look at where you can, the true operational requirements that can just take you to another level. You guys have already done well. So just go and look at that at the next level again for me.
You know what my reservations are with your business, and I had problems where I had problems and that yesterday. But you need to go in there and find more clients. One client is just not enough for the business and that. And find, get systems in place in that business. At this moment, you guys are the business. You are the magic in that business. But who runs it? Who is running this ship? So we need to get those things ready. If we can get those things right, this business is going places.
We need you guys to go and do three things. The first one is approach 4 or 5 people that can form a board of advisors. They don't have to be farmers. In fact, it needs to be, if you do have some people that are farmers, it's fine, but it needs to be a balanced board of people that are not necessarily involved with farming, but understand business. The second task is access to market. Go out there and go and look for more clients, because it is dangerous to have a business that runs on only one client. Mm. And then the last and final task, there are lots of farming companies, big, you know, grain companies, equipment companies, etc., that have a duty and a legal requirement to do enterprise development. You guys are young emerging farmers. I think you need to package yourself in a really nice, funky, sexy way. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the external advice can help you do that. And go out there and look for funding and support, yes, in the form, different types of forms, mm-hmm, from different enterprise development, yes, entities. So Martin's going to give you our way forward and what's going to happen. But all of us agree that you guys have got a fantastic business. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, guys, I don't think we can say that enough. You really have a great business, but unfortunately, we're not going to be calling you back to the next round.
Okay. And it really must be important. We understand that it's not because of the quality of your business. Yeah. There are two reasons. One, we don't believe an implement or a yes, structure, mm, where you can store your implements is what you necessarily need right now. I think you've got a more urgent need for cash flow,
operational, mm,
because you're running out of money, mm, January, February,
yes,
and that's what you've projected. Mm. You've got an urgent need for cash flow there. Mm. So what you're asking for is totally not what this business needs the most urgently right now, okay, which is what this money is for. Also, the size of your business. We've got a lot of really small businesses where 50,000 is going to really move the needle, mm, and make a big difference. With you guys, you're a big business. 50,000, it's like pouring 50 rand worth of petrol in Lucas's car. Now, if you've seen Lucas's car, you'll know 50 rand worth of petrol will not even move the needle a little bit. And we're afraid that that's what's going to happen, mm, if we give this money to you,
that's
guys.
True.
Okay. Guys, thank you very much. And best of luck. Yeah?
Thank you
very much. I think it makes a lot of difference going back, especially with mindset, you know, having had the opportunity to look at things from a different perspective. Yes, it's cool because going back, now we know at least story. There are a few things that we thought were okay, but clearly we need to work on them and to perfect them as well.
Maybe the business can really grow, you see. Ah, see, we have good sums. To build up the structure is not enough, but anyway, Google Work is not about 50,000.